Hi, I'm John Riley here at the Memphis Drum Shop. Very happy to be with Mr. Paul Francis, a great cymbal maker from Zildjian. And we're standing in front of an empty display case that had been contributed to the Memphis Drum Shop by Greg Caputo. In that case was one of the most famous ride cymbals in drumming history, the cymbal that Joe Morello played on the hit song Take Five, which was recorded in 1959 by the Dave Brubeck Quartet. Now we have the original cymbal, and through the efforts of Jim Pettit and Paul Francis, we have a replica or recreation of that same beautiful crystal clear tone of the original 20-inch A Zildjian. Paul, how did you go about trying to recreate this zone, this sonic zone?
Well, Jim was kind enough to send it to the Zildjian factory for us to look at. And as a cymbal maker, and I'm just gonna pick it up as I do with cymbals, is we like to look at the cup shape, the curvature, the type of hammering. And this cymbal has developed a nice kind of patina, but you can see there's some distinctive hammering on here. We want to look at the curvature, and we want to weigh it. We also look at the lathing. This has the prototypical tonal grooves in it, like an A Zildjian cymbal would have. So I had similar blanks rolled. We put in the new one, a cup that's very similar to the old, our medium cup. And then I had the cymbal hammered, and I kind of borrowed from a couple different series. One is the A Zildjian series, of course, because this is an A Zildjian that would have been made probably 1957, 1958. And this has A hammering, and I also kind of borrowed the tooling from a range of cymbals that we made for a little while called A Zildjian and CIE.
Oh, yes.
So shaped the cymbals, hammered the cymbals, and then I lathed all of the recreations that Jim asked for. And we really got into that same kind of crystalline stick definition and sonic texture of the original. And I was extremely surprised how beautiful this cymbal was in person, because I'm very aware of the recording. And it's really spot on. Sometimes you get recordings and, you know, that you have some room ambiance and stuff like that that could change some of the sounds of the instrument, but that didn't happen here. So we have a faithful recreation, similar trademark that would have been put in. And on the bottom side, we did print Zildjian on it, and the weight, because these are falling within the weight range of that specific cymbal, and then just a little serial number on the bottom just to have a little traceability for it. So there's the recreation, and I think we matched it.
Well, I think so too, especially after playing them both. It's also interesting if you can see this photo of the recording studio that Joe had only one cymbal, and he was able to carry the groove and play through the solo of this 5 minute or so song using only one cymbal. And so that speaks to the quality of the cymbal, but also the variety and beauty of his touch. But to be able to capture that essence, what, 50 years later,
right,
or 60 years later,
yeah,
is a fantastic achievement. And I think these are really unique enough from the A's that are available that there's a place in the sound spectrum for this kind of cymbal.
Yeah, they're beautiful. So in the last Take Five cymbal documentary, you said you wanted to hear the cymbal. So John, let's hear you play the cymbals.